Hello friends, my name is Isaac and welcome back to my channel where I share useful tech tips to help you do great work. Let's get started. The first step is to create a restore point so that in case something doesn't go well, you can always revert to your old state. To do that, we go to start, search for restore, and then select create a restore point. Check to see if protection is turned on. So I'll click on drive C, configure, turn on system protection, apply, okay. Once that's activated, come here to create and let's name this before delete. Create restore point successfully created. Great. The first step in cleaning up files is to use the disk cleanup. So I'll go to start, search for disk cleanup, select drive C, and then clean up system files. Okay. Then I want to make sure that I've checked everything here. And currently it's going to save me only 1 GB, not much, but let's do that. All right, so that's done. Refresh. And I have a slight increase over here. The next step is probably the best one. We are going to use a free tool called TreeSize. The link is in the description below. Or you can open your browser, go to google.com and then search for TreeSize. You want this right here and then click on free download. Download this tool and complete the installation. Once you are done, you come to start menu and then you search for TreeSize and you have two options. I'll select the one with administrator, click on that. Yes. From the home tab, select directory, choose your local disk C, give it some time to scan. Okay, so it's done scanning my entire drive. And then you want to make sure that this is sorted by size. So let's click on this just to make sure it's sorted by size. I see Isaac has taken up a lot of disk space. So let's check. Within Isaac, I see app data, something you don't want to touch. Apple. So I backed up my phone using iTunes and that's why it's giving me this. But I don't need this anymore. So I'll go ahead and then delete this. Delete. Yes. The next I want to do in my case is desktop is taking about 10 gig, which I think is too much. I don't want so many files on my desktop. So if I need those files, then I would have to copy them to another drive. If not, then I can delete them. In my case, I'm not sure. So let me copy them. In fact, let me cut that and then open my other drive and let's say, do I have a desktop folder? I don't. Let me create a new folder, call it desktop, and then I'll paste everything in here. Let's get back, close the desktop. Miniconda, I use that for programming. Documents, 2 GB, that's fine. Download, that's fine. So basically go through this tree and then try to figure out what is taking up space. Now the next step is to check for programs I no longer use. For that, I'll go to start menu, search for programs. Make sure you have this sorted by size, large to small. Going through one, I see DaVinci Resolve 7.95 gig, that's fine. But I see another DaVinci Resolve here. I'm not sure. I would have to investigate that. So basically, go through this and then if there are any large softwares or programs you don't use again, you can just uninstall them by clicking these three dots and then uninstall. If you really need a particular program, there's another option that might allow you to move that program to another drive. So for instance, in my case, I know Arc Browser has that option. So I click on this move. Then I can select to move it to drive E. I'm not going to do that. Unfortunately, not all the apps have this option. In fact, very few apps have this option. Now let's go back and check my space. And whoops, great. The last piece is to set up storage sense. That will clean up the system files for you automatically. And this is critically important in maintaining the sanity of your PC. So let's go to start, search for storage settings. So right there, you see storage sense. And if in your case it's unchecked, make sure it's turned on and then click on this. And then check the following boxes. Keep Windows running smoothly by automatically cleaning up temporary system and app files. You want to check that. Automatic user content cleanup. So storage sense will run when disk space is low. You want to have that checked. Then clean up shadows. So run storage sense when disk is low. That is by default. I want to change that to maybe every week. Delete files in my recycle bin if they've been there for over 30 days. I think that's fair. And delete files in my download folder if they haven't been opened for more than, let's say, 60 days for me is fine. And then if you have cloud drives linked up to your PC, that could also be taking up storage. If some of those files are available offline, content will become online if not open for more than. So let's say if I haven't opened a particular file for 14 days, then I want it to go back online because I'm not using it actively. I'll do same for my OneDrive, 14 days. And you can decide to even run storage sense now. If you're interested in finding anything faster on Windows, click here.